Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the International Qualifiers, the Western part of it. We're here for day two of your action, and we're into game number two of game number two.
Which
of
could
today.
Very well be the last. If RoXKIS puts on the same performance they just did, it's probably tonight's last match, and we'd have the two first teams advancing to the playoffs. However, AL is not out of the race yet.
That is true, man. That is true. If AL don't go greedy on us, maybe there's a chance.
What happened yesterday was RoXKIS won the first game against AL in a very convincing manner. Not as convincing as this game just now, but they did win in a convincing manner. And what AL responded with was winning the next game in a convincing manner. So the same thing can happen. It's anyone's game still. But RoXKIS looked very, very solid.
Yeah, that they did, man. That they did. We're talking about them in the break as well, and it's impressive. It's impressive, focused Russian Dota.
It's definitely some of the most disciplined Russian Dota I have ever seen. Like Solo goes on his little adventures on his own, but other than that, those. It works every time, so you can't really blame him. But other than that, it's team play all around, and it's beautiful to watch.
Yeah. Well, man, let's go into our draft right now because I'm already seeing absolute legends. They are baiting the Wisp through. Batrider or Wisp will get through. Biz, actually, I'm wondering if Mania is saying, you know what?
Yeah, let's leave everything in the pool.
We're going to ban out CK, so you'll want to take Batrider. But even then, Tiny, as well as us, we saw their effectiveness yesterday. But RoXKIS, I'm wondering if they feel like they've been handed a silver platter right now. They're being asked if they also want to dance with death, and they're actually going to give over the Wisp themselves.
Oh, that's a Wisp first pick for the AL team, and that's a good first pick for them, knowing that RoXKIS isn't really too prone to play neither Lone Druid nor Nyx. I'm assuming Nyx is a fairly solid pickup right now, but I don't think they're going to go with the Lone Druid. I haven't seen RoxKiss play Lone Druid once, so...
Neither have I.
Starting now would be unlikely, but...
But then again, we also weren't used to seeing Unicorn play Lone Druid either, so...
Well, it's a farming hero, so it's not completely out of his scope.
That's just when you start to micro as well as farm at the same time. Yeah. If your fingers is just too much for a man, we can't all control Chen like you.
Well, I think he was doing pretty well with his Lone Druid in both the games he played yesterday.
Yeah. Well,
there's the Nakes. And the Darkseer instantly coming off, so RoxKiss already has a plan. Laid out.
Well, their plan is basically what they've already done. It's just basic for them. Darkseer, Dread gets to take that one up. Biz will walk around the Nakes. It's like, okay, let's just go kill everything the way we normally do. If they want to initiate, if Wisp wants to come in and try and get a Tether Stun, Rage, possibly Infest.
Yeah.
Darkseer's got a Surge to get away or a repositioning ability too. If everyone's got some strength behind them and the ones that don't have strength stick with somebody else in the pair, Wisp can't gank up. Like, you were watching a game early today. You're watching it from the AMD Premier League, weren't you? And like,
yes.
We saw Wisp failing very, very badly up against Tongfu.
Rising Stars, not very, very badly, but it wasn't played to the extent of the old Empire team, for instance. They were really, really successful with the Wisp CK. Fnatic as well. They weren't as successful, but it might have something to do with the level of play that Tongfu displayed. So that's... Oh, and Magnus comes out from AL, so they've completely changed their game around in terms of picks, because Mac was available last time around in the first pick phase, and they didn't pick it up. So this time... And I want to comment on the bans. You can see AL was actually prepared to give away Wisp in case they got the Batrider in trade, because they banned out the CK, so they were like, all right, we can afford giving them the Wisp if they don't ban it by banning out the CK instead.
Yeah,
but this way we can actually bait them into giving us Batrider. That's their train of thought. And then when they banned the Batrider, they were like, okay, we need to go with the Wisp then.
Yeah.
Because there's no trade to be made.
Well, there's no way you would want to give an option where you gave a Wisp to RoXKIS in any situation.
Yeah, and this is something I trust AL to play in a much better fashion than they did last time around. They're good with the Nature's Prophet. It's a hero that fits them well because it's a semi-carry hero that can split push a ton, farm up items very quickly, and it's what AL is looking to do. They want multiple carry heroes, basically.
At the same time, do you actually remember the roster that Tongfu was playing? Because remember, Clockwork was actually in the lineup.
Tongfu had a Pandaren Brewmaster, so that's annoying to play against as a Wisp. They had the Clockwork, which is also annoying to play against as a Wisp. And and they had a ton of other heroes. Hmm. All three.
Surprised that Absolute Legends even picked up Nature's Prophet in third. Unless they'll worry about Nakes and Nature's Prophet jumping around the map. Because now RoXKIS has a free option to ban out every single major hero that will work with a Wisp.
Well,
I say every single hero.
There's a ton of heroes that works with Wisp. Like, they could even get greedy and go with a Stealth Assassin. I think that's one of the best Wisp combos there is.
Well, that was the... Loda used to run that one.
Yeah, it's just so very public play-ish to do, but it's still a good way to play. It's just hard to play against 5-on-5 Dota because they'll just get a gem and you can't really do anything with the SA. He loses his ultimate. Another thing they could do was go Ursa. We've seen a lot of Ursa play lately. We've seen it with Venomancer, but it can be easily be paired up with the Wisp too. It's still a strong pick. It's something next KC did like 18 months ago and with much success when they were at their peak. Still a killer combo, but yeah. They've banned out the most obvious choices for the Wisp, definitely.
Yep, and Alchemist is taken out too, so it kind of almost says they don't want to run an aggressive trial line, because I just want to point like SD and Lina. Still most definitely available here in the pool, as if they wanted to run like Darkseer up against a Mag or Clock up against a Mag in the middle lane.
Yeah, like Ale's lanes are sort of already determined. They're definitely going to safe lane.
Yeah.
They're probably going to start the Furion in the jungle, and they're going to have the Mag mid. So RoXKIS knows what to expect from them, and in turns, Ale might have a pretty good idea that it's a support Clockwork again, it's an offlane Darkseer again, and it's a... and that's the Ursa.
This just feels like next KZ all over again, man.
Well, the Ursa is good against next too, so it's a fine pickup, and it takes down heroes really fast with the Wisp when they relocate.
The thing though, which they've got to check for, is level 1 Roshan.
That's true. Like, there's a definite possibility of AL doing Rose. They don't even need it, but they could even go Empower on Magnus, and they have the Transform Furion. They have the easily do a Rose attempt. But there's a Clockwork on the enemy team.
Let's see if he goes RoXKIS first. Most Clockworks normally go Cogs first.
Yeah, but even then, like...
If you feel the problem, then
imagine
you
Clockwork running into the Rose pit when they're standing hitting Rose and Rose is hitting them.
And they pop the Cogs.
They all get stunned back into Rose. Rose might get a kill or two.
Yeah.
The Cogs last for a long time. There's nothing they can do about it other than take all the damage from Rose. It's actually quite fearsome.
Well, Mania... What are we going to do, man? 22 seconds left on the clock now. An absolute legend. An Ursa Warrior plus the Wisp. The thing which actually NextKZ used to do with this was actually only leave Wisp and Ursa on the bottom lane. And they would take Roshan. No matter what happened, they would go in and they would take Roshan. If RoXKIS would come up to them, they'll just fall themselves back.
Yeah.
And now VS, this is so looking like a level 1. But yeah, all you have to do is just move in and out, and they'll go between the Ancient Stack and Roshan. Until they got like the levels up and running, if they needed to, the bottom tier 1 tower, if it went down, didn't care. All they want to do is take out Roshan and keep the focus of the enemy on them. And that's what SKC did beautifully. And let all the other lanes have so much space and freedom, because everyone else is saying, damn it, they're going to go Roshan soon, everyone's going to bonus 200 gold, blah, 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 what's going to go on here?
Yeah.
And if they do claim Roshan, you're instantly up to level 5 with just the two of you.
Yeah.
By the point, yeah, you get to killing it. So yeah, something to keep in mind, and I doubt RoXKIS again let them. Like, level 1 fight though for RoXKIS, like, you're talking about Clockwork being good, but if he puts up those Cogs, Snakes, Darkseer, SD, plus 1, which I'm still assuming to be a Lina.
No, they need the solo mid right now. It's solo 0 that's left.
You're saying that y'all will be Clockwork Goblin again?
Yeah. I definitely think so. The question is what solo will play. I don't think they're going to go for the Juggernaut again, but they have done it with Darkseer a lot since they feel that kind of pushes strong. But this time around, they don't have a Gyro, they have a Lifesteal, and there's a big difference in the two when you're pushing. I'm not sure why AL picked up the Vengeful Spirit. It's sort of good to start fights with, because you can swap, and then they need to initiate. You can pick off the Darkseer with it, take him out of the fight early on, and when they go on you with the swap, this is something you did in Ancient Dota before Magnus was even an issue. You'd have ES and VS on the same team, and you'd counter-initiate on your own initiate. So he'd swap someone, they'd go in and help their mate that swap, and BAM! In comes the Echo Slam, or in this case, the Reverse Polarity.
Yeah.
So, Outworld Devourer, picked up by...
What about the old combination, man? Techies, Minds, and VS swap.
Yeah, still a beauty, but there's no Techies in the game. And
no! Ice, why?
Ice doesn't look like he has any rush of... putting it in.
Maybe he's one of those guys that just hates playing up against Techie, so he's like purposefully delaying it.
Yeah, I could picture him getting annoyed by being blown up by 6 Minds lying on the rune spot.
I don't see that as annoyance. I see that as beautiful poetry in motion.
Definitely.
That's what it is, man. All right, so OD, final pickup, RoXKIS.
It's RoXKIS still relies on going together because Wisp has a field day picking off these heroes, I feel like. And in the, like, Ursa and Wisp takes down a hero so extremely fast, it's not even funny.
I'm seeing Ring, I'm seeing two Clarys, I'm seeing Smoke, I'm seeing Trees, I'm seeing...
Spawn, there's a Basilisk on the Furion. Well,
Ursa's, Clarities, and now Smoke to go in. And I'm wondering if those lines are telling you anything from RoXKIS. Check out level 1 Roshan. For all those guys out there with a compendium saying, I said Roshan would die within 2 minutes.
I don't think that was it. They're just, like, drawing waves.
No, their line's drawn. They're drawing the line to... What the hell is that? To go around?
How do you go around with the tier 1 tower?
You can't. And Dread E is coming in with Cox.
Yep.
So they're starting up on Roshan.
Oh, do it. Do
there's
it.
No wa- there's oh. a ward outside of Dread. They got to get the stun. They get the stun. It was a bait, really. And there's Dread. What the hell?
What?
Miracle gets forced so far up the hill. And now Biz is in there with an Iron Shell. They're going to try and bring down Mania. They do finish the job. It's a 1-1 action right now. And poor Miracle stuck on the hill. There's a bit of a disruption. They're looking for Miguel. Is Unicorn trying to cut his way through? He eats Miracle out of the tree line.
Absolute mayhem. And I think RoXKIS came out as the winners because there was like...
Well, no, First Blood still went the way of Absolute Legends.
Yeah, Rise, yeah, that's true, that's
Wisp
true.
Killed off Clockwork. And that means Wisp now has money, which means possible earn, it means possible bottle early on too.
Yeah, I was just thinking that the Ursa just used all of his eaters to get the VS out, but obviously First Blood is a lot better. So I think they'll be happy with that trade.
Yeah. So they go over to the lanes, First Blood's down, and that was the other option for them. They had one ward, and I'm surprised before RoXKIS went in they didn't throw a Sentry or Observer up there to check out for it, but it did really feel like a bait from AL. Like, the lineup was so damn obvious they were going for Roshan. At the end of the day, they said, well, you come and contest us, and we'll kill the first hero that comes in. Go me Clockwork? Fantastic, let's do it.
In some sense, that was a very clowny screw. I can't help but think they could just all gather around him when the VS stunned and just, if you want to cock, you're going to cock yourself into death.
I'm almost wondering, trouble for Unicorn, so he'll be back in a moment. I'm actually wondering if VS wasn't on the cliff then, if AL would have kept going. If AL would have actually finished up Roshan. Like they killed off Clockwork, okay.
No, but RoxKiss kept on fighting.
Yeah, but that's because VS wasn't there anymore. Like, VS wasn't... I know she like threw one stun out and then basically didn't have much left to throw, but...
No, I think RoxKiss would have kept on fighting regardless. They had decent level 1 fighters. I mean, Iron Shell, Anakes, Shadow Demon. Did he go for Poison or did he go Disrupt?
Good question.
Oh, he went for Disrupt, huh? He could have pulled an IX Mike and just spammed the shit out of it with Poison and get a triple kill early on.
Well, it's like, keep going for Roshan. Keep going for Roshan. I'll keep stacking you.
Yeah, exactly.
Interesting how well Dread does up here on the top lane up against Unicorn and the two supports, of course.
Yeah, so this is a trading farm war. Mm. In every other game we've seen RoXKIS play, they've actually fought the tri-lane head-on and won every single time.
Well, normally, yeah, even if the Clockwork's up here, he's normally got double support. There's four heroes now coming up to the top lane. This is going to be a move.
That should be a death. He's very far up.
Ryze will just tether into Unicorn right now, and the line is right to tether up on Dread. There's no Spirits, but the stun's going to be there, which means he's going to get a secondary tether stun right now if possible. Dread's taking so much damage, it's going to be a second. Is he trying to deny himself to this tier 1 tower or just waste that time and pull him away from the creep wave?
Yeah, they weren't really maximizing their spell efficiency. Miracle coming off with the stun immediately after the Earth Shock, so. That could have been executed better, but they got the job done. So, but very very far up play from Dread. Bit surprised he had the cojones to go that far up.
I just want to check back to our middle lane too. Very very even across that. Normally you say OD will take this one out, but he's taken 2 points of the intelligence out from Miguel. But it's bottle up and your balls. And actually a hell of a lot more of effective. Actually, it was you guys that did it with Demon.
Did what?
You guys did it with Demon. He played, what hero was it?
What did we do?
Maybe it was when you're on holiday as well. It was a Demon. Demon's hero basically roamed around because he had no items apart from just the level 1 bottle.
Oh, Tidehunter.
That's right, Tide Gush.
Offlane Tidehunter with a bottle where he just harasses the shit out of the middle lane instead of being in the lane or jungling or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of like turns Miguel into something like that. You run one bottle on Shockwave and then run one bottle Shockwave and then you're out.
Yeah.
Except he's being forced into it by Solo.
It's a bit playing against an Obsidian. Oh, sorry, Outworld. Just Devourer.
OD. It works.
OD.
Well, there goes Ryze's mana.
Overdose.
Interesting to see what Ryze actually... Oh, where's that rocket? Oh, Ryze.
Would have been beautiful for the Clockwork to actually get a kill on that lane.
One way to turn it around for RoXKIS. But he actually feels so much confidence going up against Unicorn. One thing he doesn't want to do is cog up and then find Unicorn inside the cogs with him. So that's the one thing at all costs to avoid.
They're actually going to put the Daxia off on top now, alongside the Clockwork, to sort of force ALN to paying attention to the lane and keeping the Ursa from farming, while Nyx is obviously still going to farm on bottom lane, because Furion has resorted into jungling. And middle lane is quite handily won by the OD in terms of CS. He has 9 Denies and 5 CS more than the Magnus already. And it's only going to progress even further when he hits 5 and then 7.
And Miracle's very, very narrow line of sight, but it's very obvious now Yol and Dread are together. They still want to gank here.
I don't think they can. Ooh.
Oh, well done, Prophet. Kill off fire neutral.
That's interesting. Did he bank? It must have been on purpose.
No, he's still got extra cash sitting there, man. Meanwhile, up on the top lane, Yol, there's a tether coming in. Dread, wonderful cogs.
How do you kill that lane?
You can't. You can't. You can't get past cogs.
And...
unless you want to fall stuff and take the damage yourself, but you don't have that.
Both of the heroes are so tanky that by the time that the stun wears off, either the cog is going to save the Darkseer, or the Darkseer is going to search the Clockwork if they go on him.
Mm. Or the creep wave takes all your life points because it's got 2 iron shells on it.
They got their game plan down every game, RoXKIS. I'm so impressed. I know I'm just on their balls all day long, but...
yeah, you should manage RoXKIS, man, not AG.
Let's see. Tomorrow's the day.
Only if RoXKIS get picked up by Razor,
Monster, yeah. Astro, yeah. etc.
You're only here for the sponsors. Knew it. Freaking knew it. It's not the game that you love. This should be able to take this tower. Even with the trees pulling the aggro down, it looks like Biz is like, well, okay. Give me the experience, let me have level 6, and then I'll most definitely kill you. Top lane, Miracle. My Dread and Yol. Like, it's not even like, can they kill Yol or Dread? It's like, can Yol or Dread kill them?
Yeah, they're actually putting on the aggression. Now, that's because Wisp and Vengeful are both super squishy heroes with little to punish them with. So, unless the Ursa gets...
well, Ursa needs Wisp as well as VS. Without it, he can't kill.
Yeah, exactly. So, and he's low right now, so they can really punish them.
So interesting to see his build-up. Not maxing out the Fury Swatch. He's put 2 points now into the Ursa.
It is a fairly... decent spammable spell, but not really needed in that lane. Like
he's never getting close to Yol or Dread. It's
well, early on when there was only a Clockwork, he needed the level 1 of it. But having it on level 2 doesn't really seem needed. Yeah. I don't know.
Maybe it's going to work now with the phase boots up and running.
Tweets his own.
Yeah, everyone likes something different. DKs with no brief fire. Everyone likes something different.
Yeah.
I'm never going to stop referencing that, man.
No, that's still a weird.
It's still weird, but for some reason, sometimes it works. Hand of Myers on Lifestealer. See how much harassment he's taken.
Yeah.
Still got the double tango.
Almost a waste. I don't know why they opted to actually fool that guy. They might as well have given it to the OD or the clock.
Well, now the OD's running Tranquil Boots in the middle lane.
Yeah, he's going to go for the mech again. We saw this yesterday. They went mech and then into a Scythe of Vice on him. And they did.
Oh man, he's trying to get some farm on the Ancients, and now going to TP out Disruption. He gets it.
Oh.
Only just in time, but there's going to be a open wounds and, well, no, infest damage off the back of Vanscore.
I think he could have just hit that. There was a curse on him. He would have died without the infest.
Maybe just trying to be special. Unicorn, now with that clap, and then, oh, inside the cogs. Never where you want to be, but then Unicorn, he's getting bumped around 3 different times from the cogs, and then thinking about Ryze, that's not going to work nicely. Ryze only got 1 more Ball Spirit to let off. Oh. Yol gets a bit of a Paw Swipe Mania, looking for a Sprat, and he got Yol. There's no back, and the cogs, they come up to try and push Unicorn back further, and what a position for it! Unicorn's almost dying from these cogs. Yol wants back out again. He's going to surge himself, but there's no stuns. No, wait, no, there's Miracle. SD comes in too, and he holds Miguel out of here. They brought everybody towards this top lane.
They just committed 5 heroes into a gang that didn't work.
Wow.
And you can just hear Unicorn on their voice program. Fuck this!
Yes. He could push back. What was that in total? 6 times
the
cogs got him?
Yeah, I think that was 6 times.
three from the engagement over here, and then three from the freaking cogs. Which it's like, it was a sprout. It was a sprout in a Darkseer who didn't have a point in VAC. He didn't have a tango on this top lane, and I look at you, Nakes, he didn't have a tango on this top lane to get himself out of the tree line.
But Sprout really didn't do anything from neither side. Like, it didn't do anything for
it. It would have allowed the Ursa to come straight in and then start hitting on him. That's what I saw it as. Because the Ursa had to catch up.
Did he have a treat on the Ursa? Because he needed to be really, really... No, he didn't.
No.
That's the only way I could have seen that Sprout helped them the least bit. I mean, I would have done the same, no doubt about it, but it's just...
Miracle. You can be really careful about this Prophet. Dredge right here, too. Oh,
he's got that ultimate up. He can kill the VS.
No. Yep. That's why I thought Miracle would be a little bit more careful about that.
And this is just what we see AL do repeatedly, game after game. Going for the gank, having the gank turned on them, dying. It's painful to watch as a Dane.
Well, because all these guys are your friends too.
Like, yeah, they are.
You've known these guys for a very, very long time.
Forever. Longer than I've known my mother. Ish.
Did you, like, shake hands as sperm Dyer's with Miguel? Tower is under
attack. We were semen brothers.
Fantastic. Really shouldn't have gone there. maybe somewhere else you shouldn't go bottom lane, Mania. Vanskor sitting here with an Invis rune, just waiting for it to come out just far enough. And now that's far enough. Open wounds, poison. It's not going to work to TP out this one. It's the same situation again. Biz, I don't think he's going to use Infestation to kill him off again this time. Mania will go down the old-fashioned way. He'll have to use Infest to get away from that tower.
He might have actually been able to get away because the curse hit a creep instead if he didn't Infest. He didn't Infest, though.
Yeah, safety anyway.
Yeah, but there's nothing you can do against a gang like that. Sucks playing for him like that. He'd probably be better off. I know he wanted to defend the tower, but he'd be better off like summoning some of the trees in the base, having run down on their own and just...
Oh, Unicorn. It's going to happen all over again. He lets off the Clamper with the Surge on Dread. It was almost like bait, and now Miguel... Well, he's got an RP and he wants a kill. He's got Yol right here, just body blocking him for now. Shockwave as well. One more hit from the Ursa and they get themselves a kill. And then Cogwork just bounces out Miguel. Oh, disruption. He didn't go on Unicorn, however. Unicorn face boots, but he held out the RP.
You can't help but think that RoXKIS is just teasing them. It feels like they're just playing around with them and just making fun of them. Like
some people throw money. RoXKIS,
it's not like RoXKIS isn't getting anything out of it either. Like they get the farm on the Knicks and that's about it.
Oh, Miguel.
Well, he would have the screw off in 5 seconds, but it's annoying.
We thought it was a light of heaven moment. Get caught on that high ground. Biz has an arm. This is 10 minutes in with a hand of Midas.
An armless, yeah.
He doesn't have phase boost or any kind of treads or anything like that, but he doesn't need it. It's 76 for 10 on this bottom lane.
Yeah, they're going to have to rely on the reverse polarity to kill the Knicks, because Ursa and the Wisp Stun won't do it.
Has Unicorn got enough movement speed?
He does. He definitely does, but they still need the... Oh, he comes in from behind.
Yep, now there's a chance. Dread, though, Dread Cogs, and Unicorn again. Just bump him up, and Miguel's going to get hit by that as well, and then he RPs, but he only gets one. Vanskor's coming through the side, Disruption as well as Catcher up on Unicorn. Whisper's already there because Biz, well, he was farming in the bottom lane, now he's on the top lane with an Infest as well. He was thinking about that. There's a Surge in. OD in from the side! Then the Disruption up and running, and Biz's like, well, this one's mine. Miguel, get over here, and there we go, Infestation, not enough. Darkseer takes it with the Iron Shell.
It's the same teams like yesterday, and it's the same... plays like yesterday and today, and it's the same mistakes over and over again, and it's a damn shame. Every time AL tries to go for a gang with all the best intentions in the world, RoXKIS is immediately there to turn it around and just kill them instead. It happens every single time. And, you know, one couldn't help but think that they should have just waited for the cogs to go down and then go in, because there was no way out for those two heroes. Well, TP scrolls, obviously, but...
It was just forced. It was just
Miguel
forced.
Just looked like he was agitated, and I'm like, screw you, I'm going to skewer in and solo RP you, and we're going to make the best of it.
Maybe they did feel pressure, because OD was rotating up, and he came right underneath the Observer Ward.
Yeah.
And they might have gone, kill him, so now we can deal with the OD, because they can't deal with the OD as it is.
Well, yeah, I probably would have done the exact same thing. It's just painful to watch how good RoXKIS is at counterattacking.
Unicorn. Now we get to see that man fight up. Ryze trying to get the tether stun, and Rage. Unicorn's already dead.
Yeah.
It's Sprout will come off from Mania, but Mania is dealing with an OD right behind him. Another open wound, and now Bid on a killing spree.
That's what an Omni next 10 minutes in is going to do to you. It doesn't matter if you're a Nursa. And they just took their entire stack.
I don't even want to... I didn't want to bring up that graph.
Ouch.
I did not want to bring up that graph.
What level is VS?
VS?
What level is Wisp?
In fact, I'm going to give you all the levels, man, just because you're asking.
Wisp is 6, but...
But, like, what are you going to ulti on?
Yeah, there's nothing to ulti on.
he can go with Unicorn, but...
And there's zero damage
output. But now it's 5-man Dota. They realize Wisp is level 6. They've taken out all the outer T1 towers now. But, like, even if killing off SD, I don't see it possible. Darkseer, like, mech is almost done for him. Not possible. Rod of Atos is up on the OD. At 13 minutes in with Tranquil Boots.
There's close to zero damage output in the AL lineup
and
right now.
There's the Rod. Wait,
reverse
what?
Polarity
what?
And
what?
Ursa.
Oh, he went invis. I was wondering what was going on there. I was like, wait, he just imprisoned him. It should be fine.
Oh, they're going for the Rose. Desperate times call for desperate measures. And I don't think RoXKIS is even thinking about this right now. They feel so confident in their play. And
well, they're killing everybody else, man.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, he gets lucky. Nice tree block.
Basically, they're in such a happy state right now that they're not even considering the option of Rose going down.
Yep. But they get it. So Aegis the Immortal. Unicorn's going to sell shield, picks up the Aegis.
He's going to have his Vlads now. It's not going to mean a whole
just
lot.
Just short. Ryze is looking for a kill. They want to go bottom lane. Like, Mag is waiting here with an RP saying, please, 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 bring some help to me.
And there's no wards on the rocks here, so they don't actually know. They just spotted him out. You see the Shadow Demon.
One observer.
Oh, there is an observer right there.
Watching Miracle come down as well. Damn, that's an aggressive ward from RoXKIS. Wherever that Wisp is, if they're like prepping for something, they want to know about it. And Miguel gonna TP or that
where
poison.
Where is Clock? Where is Clock? Oh, he's so close.
Oh! He still threw it out of just sheer hopefulness. Meanwhile, up on the top lane, there's your actually killing spree being ended by Mag. RP yet to be used as well as Ryze's ultimate. He's not gonna take anybody back apart from himself to death.
Yeah, it's worth it at this stage of the game to basically throw everything they have on an Aegis. They need the kills, they need to shut down their carries, so using an RP for a hero like that, no problem.
You kill the highest level on the map, it's like,
yeah,
there's as much experience as you can possibly get.
There's against some level advances. The thing is, if you compare late gamers right now, an Aegis is better, like has a lot better farm than the Ursa, and OD has a lot better farm than the Furion, and Darkseer is probably more farmed than anyone on the AL lineup too. So,
yep.
Tough times.
It is, man. It is. It kind of feels like watching Tuskar play. Snowball. It's coming, man.
Snowball?
It's coming. It's like Jack Frost.
Oh, that kind of snowball.
Yeah. As in like a ball of snow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, are there
no!
Any, are there
no!
Any other snowballs?
No! 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 Fight that backdoor regen, RoXKIS. TP's to the bottom lane, so Mania already TPing out Cogs. Cancel off his TP. He's only just got enough mana for another one. Dread tries to get close enough for the battery assault.
That's why Furion is a good hero against a Clockwork, because you can sprout those treants and his mini stuns won't hit you. Oh, well, the chances decrease a lot.
Mm-hmm. Just make this buffer between you and him. I was flying in there.
Things are looking really good. You see, oh, Odie has a Rod of Aethers and a Ghost Scepter, so the Ursa can't even
Ryze might be in a little bit of trouble. I'm seeing an OD ulti trigger the Aegis Immortal on the Ursa. Ryze, ulti will take him out. He couldn't actually...
Oh, he's earned. He's going to die to the urn, and Ursa...
Unicorn, TP, they're going to find
what?
Him. Fact, something, nothing!
What?
Back on cooldown, no mana on the clockwork, disruption from SD. I've got a feeling it was on cooldown.
That's so unlucky that if Clock had rocket vision, they could have easily gotten him.
Beer's looking for free gold. Rage, Miracle can still swap him, but that doesn't affect Beer's at all. 5 hits to victory. And he's building into a Desolator. And this will be bottom tier 2 tower as well.
How close is he to the Desolator?
He's a mithril hammer. Second mithril hammer.
Ouch.
So, recipe away.
He's so very farmed. This feels like we're a lot further in because of the farm on the RoXKIS lineup.
Yeah.
But in reality, it's 17 minutes. And they're going to push into the base, and what's going to stop them? There's one AoE hero on AL's lineup, and it's their initiate. He does have that blink, but they have zero follow-up. They have zero damage output. They're going to need, like,
the best reverse in of his life, followed up by a double tether situation.
Mania, that's amazing. No. Oh, he got it! He got the disruption! There's a whole lot of trees
here. Oh, is he
going
to misclick? Oh, he is not going to misclick. There was a good chance of him misclicking that.
That's why he brought all the tree and Mania just gets destroyed.
How many deaths are that? Is he closing the Milk Award?
0-6, but the Milk Award means you have to win.
Oh, true that. And there's, as things are looking right now, there's no way.
I still have never awarded a second Milk Award. As the man who actually awarded the first Milk Award, I can say I'm the only person that could award.
I'm in the safe for now.
Yeah, it's got to be a competitive game. A full-on competitive game that I class as a competitive game.
And now AL is actually resorting to backdooring towers with the Relocate Ultimate and Ursa. Mm-hmm. And they need to do something, and I am not sure what.
The funny thing is, though, this is actually something I talked over with Puppy at EMS. And he said, he doesn't fear Wisp at all. He's happy almost to let Wisp through the pool if it wasn't just being used by everybody.
Yeah,
China
feels the
way.
Same way, and if the best Dota nation in the world...
But he said that there is one here that the Wisp should always be used with, and that's Tiny. But it's used as a town pusher.
Yeah, definitely.
Because you come in with Tiny and you have like a tree and a Daedalus or a tree as well as a Yasha, and you can destroy towers through the backdoor regen.
Well, I mean, the CK Wisp playstyle is still one of the most legit playstyles around, and I don't think Poppy can disagree. Like, Empire has shown time and time again how strong that lineup is, and mm-hmm. they have destroyed Na'Vi on LAN, online, ever since TI2, so like the old Empire.
Yeah. Not the new Empire.
Not the new Empire.
The old Empire is everywhere now.
The Empire has fallen.
It's like all those kids out there remember the old DTS.
Yeah, DTS, VP. Yes. Russia has like a golden era of teams for each year, and then they disband.
Yeah.
And sadness is to be heard.
That'd be the way of Dota, man. There's always a shuffle. Now they're going to try and gank up on the bottom lane, but I don't think they realize this isn't just Dread. And he's now going to pop off Cogs, push the Unicorn. Look at Unicorn's mana!
Boom.
He's basically out, and then Nate goes, hi, what's up? What's up, fellas?
I got a Desolator.
Oh!
Bye, Wisp. Mania!
Wisp got him out. But Wisp's coming back. Wisp is coming back. He's like, no, Unicorn.
Oh.
Like,
oh,
says,
yeah,
no.
No. Unicorn, no, please. Oh, the life of a TP hero.
The sacrificial lamb.
Oh,
the
man,
sacrificial lamb.
Sort of like playing Leoric and you're getting beat up and you reincarnate only to die again.
Oh. Such life is so hard, man. Life is so hard. And this could be RoXKIS just going for the final push. Like, RP is still up, though, but you saw him in the last fight. Like, I noticed this when they're on the fight on the tower before, and they saw the blink dagger up a mag, and instantly you saw one go this way, one go this way, one go that way, one go that way, and they basically said, okay, let's just all just basically go back that direction, because this isn't working.
Radical online extremists, beautiful play.
Mm-hmm.
16 to fall. Look at how one-sided these games they're playing is.
It's crazy, man. It feels like DD yesterday, which is the hilarious
thing.
No.
This is much more dominant than DD yesterday. DD had some close, sort of close games, but nothing of the sorts that RoXKIS has been displaying against Empire and now AL.
Man, I'm still going with my prediction that the two teams that come out of this qualifying group will be the two teams that will go to the international.
Of this group?
Yep.
So you don't think Mouse and EG... Qpad and iCop has a chance.
Just because you're here, I saw that EG has a chance. But no.
Okay.
No. I think RoXKIS as well as DD Dota will be playing the best out of Mouse Sports is the dark horse for me. Oh, nice RP! Green Cat Disruption! Vanscorp! This man is beautiful! Double kill for Solo, triple kill for Solo! And that is going to be almost a GG. Ryze is right behind it. It is an ultra kill for Solo. And it's like, Miguel, come over here. Get over here. Skewer. Pulls him in range of the tier 4 towers. Solo will have to wait. He's actually in a little trouble here.
Doesn't really matter, though, but...
Whoa,
yeah.
The towers. And the shockwave. If that shockwave hit, he'll be dead, but then they're going to earn him up.
Man, I don't know who to give MVP tonight. You know, Solo's been playing out of his mind, making kills right, left, and center.
So I want to give defense goal, man. I would want to give a defense goal.
That's what I mean. Like, his Rubik in one of the games against Empire, and then... Oh, did they do the smoke turn around again?
I think so, man. I think so. They walked out, they came back in again, and Miguel is just like, Solo has too much damage. He's got a Mystic Staff on him. He walked out just by a Mystic Staff.
I said it before, and I said it again. It's like RoXKIS is playing from a script. Everything is so put together and planned and organized that it just seems like every second of the game they have a plan for. These guys are prepared to win this qualifier.
That they are, man. That they are. The question is, how are they going to deal after having 2 days off?
I don't know, but they punish the teams the same exact way, time and time again, with the same kind of plays and the same strategies, and it's beautiful.
But it's like nothing risky. It's nothing risky for them. Like
it doesn't seem risky, but when you think about it, Solo in his Juggernaut games just went on a little adventure of his own, and now he has two Mystic Staff and goes in 60 seconds and ultis the fountain and will get like a quadruple kill, maybe a pentakill.
I think he really... really? I think at this point he doesn't even think he needs a hex. It's not required. Like most teams are like, yeah, get that disabled. Like, nope, I want mana pool.
I want to see a sept on him, but the game is not going to go that long.
I want to see a rapier. Just up on him.
No, I just want to, you know, there's nothing more satisfying than seeing an OD ultimate and have five heroes die instantly.
Oh, come on, Miguel. I believe in you, Miguel. Oh, I believe in lag hitting my computer. I believe in you, Miguel.
Oh, they've seen.
Yeah, they're gonna ward. They know he's there, and now they turn back. Is there just RP on just Biz? But he picks up Dread. He pulls Dread in. He might lose his own life, but can they kill up the clockwork? No, they can't. Dread is soloing three heroes here. Ryze wants to tether in an ulti back out again. It's not gonna be successful. There goes the VS, and it is just GG. 26-4. RoXKIS. They get eliminated by absolute legends. Hi, Ryze. Goodbye, Ryze. They get eliminated by absolute legends in the first winner's bracket semi-final.
Total score being 47-7, I want to say.
I don't even remember from the first game,
man. I think they had 3 kills in the first game, and they had 4 in this one.
It's all a blur of blood.
It's painful.
It's a blur of blood. That's all it is, man. That is a brutal. So he says there was 3. So yeah, you're right. Seven kills in total for absolute legends. But their international run ends here. Their international run will end here.
There it is.
They're back into the ultimate. Kill everyone that's AFK and then save even one with disruption. Biz, that they're all just selling up the runs and buying ghost scepters.
It didn't quite do as much damage as I expected to. Disappointed in you, Solo.
GG, man. GG. Oi, oi, oi. RoXKIS. Looking strong, man. Looking strong.
Looking... Man, I'm scared. I can't sleep tonight. I'm afraid of the radical online extremists.
Well, they'll come into the real world. Or maybe they will if they can get themselves to the international. Of course, we're going to talk about everything that happened today in a couple of moments' time as we'll go over to Zoe on her couch after a very, very short break. But Melk, man, end of game. End of game, end of Absolute Legends, end of your friends.
End of Absolute Legends.
I'm not going to say like Absolute Legends is disbanding. We're not saying or Team Empire. Boulder,
end of their
shut
run.
Up.
End of their run in the qualifier. Yeah. And, ouch.
Yeah. It's a harsh way to be eliminated, especially after you're able to take them in a best of three.
Yeah, but in a sense, it's actually it's not as harsh. Imagine if those were two close games and they fell short in both of them.
Yeah,
that's excruciating.
Like one moment where you screwed an RP up.
Yeah, where you just think you just got this one instance where you just feel like fuck. If I had just done that instead, this game. Yeah.
It could have been different.
You couldn't have done anything instead. Well, you could just sit and wait for the inevitable.
You go with the philosophy of Syndrome. He never feels depressed if he played his best.
Well, that's just a lie. Syndrome. That's just a lie.
We'll be back with the truth in a moment, guys. We'll see you soon.